Welcome to the ET197 PLC Greenhouse Project A. First thing we need to do is go to Canvas and get our Greenhouse A-197 CSV file and our Greenhouse Project A MGP file. Okay, let's go ahead and set up our operator interface terminal. So we need to open up our greenhouse project, and let's go ahead and send it to the panel. Okay, that's all we need to do for now. Okay, here we are at our Do More Designer, and let's get started with our project. So the first thing we're going to need to do, let's just go into edit mode to get everything up, and let's go ahead and import our documentation, our element documentation, and that's going to be Greenhouse A-197 CSV. All right, and let's go to Tools, Documentation Editor, and everything's right there. Good. Go back to main. Let's go back and check and make sure that our communication is set up properly. And it is not, so let's set it up at 38400. Okay, okay. And we're looking good. So let's go ahead and start with the first line. So we need to do a start. So let's do a DLX one, which is going to be our start button, and we're going to do a C0 set. So we're going to do a set. Good. And let's do our stop, which is a DLX2. Good. And let's go ahead and we're going to do a reset for C0. So this will be our set and reset. Good. So let's go ahead and accept and save. Oops, we're going to save it as a save project as, let's call it Greenhouse A-1. Okay. Yeah, we always need to save it. It's good. Okay, let's start with our heater. So he is a DLY1212. Okay, and we need our system control. And we're going to use a new function, an equal. So I have set up our DLV0 to be the binary input of our radio button on our OIT. So let's see here, one should be 30 degrees. Good. And we're also going to need this on at 50 degrees. So let's add another one of these, DLV0. And this guy is going to be 2. Okay. So we have up, control arrow up. And now what we have is our system when it's on. And our temp selector is either the first button, which is 30 degrees, or the second button, which is 50 degrees. It is going to turn on our heater. Let's go ahead and accept and save just to make sure. And let's go ahead and put in our fan one, which is DLY10, DLY10. And one, let's go ahead and put our C0. We'll come back in and fix all these so that we could do the temperature. So let's do fan 2, which is DOY11. Good, and let's put in our system coil. And let's go down one more. And let's take care of our pump. And our pump is going to be a DLY13. And let's put our control relay in. C0. Good. Okay, let's start with our pump. It should come on at 90 and 100. So let's go ahead and use our DLV0. And 100 is going to be 32, binary 32, which is going to match our radio button. So let's add another one here for 90, DLV0. And it's going to be 16. Okay, let's go up and up. Good. That takes care of our pump. So let's take care of our fan now. It's going to come on at 100 all the way down to 80. So let's start with 80. DLV0 and 80 would be 8. Okay, and we need two more. And let's go ahead and edit, insert, and let's put a couple rows on below this. Let's get some room here, and it's going to be after the cursor. Good. So let's go ahead and add another equals DLV0, and we're going to make this 16 and we're going to make this one DLV0 and we're going to make this 32. Okay, kind of out of whack, but that's okay. Control right arrow up, oops. And good. So we're going to turn on at 100, 90, and 80 should turn on our second fan. All right. Okay, so let's do fan number one. So first thing let's do is let's get some space here. Edit, insert, row, and after the cursor. Oops, let's go ahead and do some more. Edit, insert. Let's add two. We have a few of these things we're going to put in here. All righty. Let's do our equals, DLV0, and we're going to start at 4 for 70 degrees. Good. And then we're going to add another one. Let's put them over here, DLV0. Okay, and we're going to use an 8. That's 80. And let's go ahead and use another one, DLV, because the fan stays on pretty much all the time. So it's going to be 16. And we're going to do a 32, DLV, 32. Alrighty, so let's go up, control up. And control. Good. And is our fan. Now let's take care of our heat alarm. So we're going to need our control, system control, and our hot alarm is going to be DLY15. Okay, that's our hot alarm, and it is going to come on when it's 100. So we're going to use our binary number from our radio switch, and 32 represents our switch. What is going on here? There we go. Good. And that should set our hot alarm. So let's do our freeze alarm. C0 again. And let's do freeze alarm is going to be DLV0. Good. And we're going to use 1, I think. Why is this thing working so slow? Good. So let's go to, that should be good, and our freeze alarm is going to be DLX, DLY14. Good, that is our freeze alarm. Okay, this looks good, so let's go ahead and accept, write it to the PLC, save it, and let's turn the, turn the status on, so let's take a look at our run. Good, and we can see it operating, and we'll go ahead and we'll try it. Here we have our PLC and the OIT for the first project for our greenhouse. So 30 degrees, let's go ahead and turn it on, turn it off, and we should lose everything. Let's turn it on. 30 degrees, we're going to get a freeze alarm and heat. 50 degrees, we're going to get a heat, no alarm. 70, we should have fan 1 on. 80, we should have fan 2 on. 90, we should have both fans in the pump, and 100 degrees, everything should be on, and we get a hot alarm. Perfect.